Yeah, sir, we are from Uncle K Live TV. My name is Prasheed, and I'm known as Uncle K on online.
Okay.
So what we do? Oh, sorry. What we do is whatever we record, the audio we also put on our radio. So some people cannot watch our TV. So we are available on any smallest mobile anybody has. You can see and listen to us.
Okay.
So we are spread all over the world.
All over the world.
Yeah, because web TV and radio is available.
Yeah.
We don't need satellite, we don't need those things. So the reason we are doing all this is because I have been here from 1966, through the British rule. And I am proud when Dubai is growing. And
definitely,
people who come here and just bring their beautiful products, that gives people, you know, the main, Dubai was built on export and re-export and import.
I have been visiting this place since 1984.
Wow,
and I have seen the transformation of the way from a very, very remote city, I would call it, and from this very modern outlook of the way. In 84, when I used to come over here, it was not beyond the clock tower or the Dera Dubai.
And you remember that flame round they had, that flame?
Absolutely.
That was the sign when they had discovered petrol. So that was the mission. Those are the things.
So
what I'm trying to say is Mitchell is a very famous name because the ads which we see, and that impresses me also. Any company which has its own farms and own, you know, I think you have a slogan that nature,
fresh from
gave,
the farm.
Yeah, nature gave the taste, Mitchell
gave the
saved it. I don't know what
you, you are absolutely right.
Yeah. So that really struck me, and that's true. That's true. It's not just a slogan. So what,
we
tell
really
me
mean
about
it,
your farms and these things, how, because we love, even my family, they love your products.
Okay.
But
thank you very much.
How, because I've been here so long, I don't go back that often.
I see.
So
but you belong to Pakistan?
Yes, I was born in 1946.
Where in
Karachi.
In Karachi.
So where are these farms? And I mean, it must be near in Punjab or something.
Absolutely, absolutely right. In fact, the great Mitchell, the original,
British, it must be a
absolutely, absolutely. After the First World War, the brothers, Mitchell brothers, decided to, let's say, to go into somewhere where they can contribute towards this agriculture business and agriculture lands and all that. So the Mitchells.
So their background was agriculture.
There was not. They in fact, in UK, they were the family who was in doing some other businesses, not the agriculture based. But somehow they got through this British rule the land, the know-how about this agriculture based, for example, this oranges. Then they grew up with this special kind of lemon, lime, into the area where we are right now, which is about 120 kilometers from Lahore, which is near to district Okhada, which is called Nala.
So would that be particularly an orange area? Majority of the crops there are orange?
Right now, the major crop of the oranges and the kinu has shifted to another place, which is called Surgoda. But this soil is again good for this kind of lemon, lime, oranges.
Citric.
Right? So, from there onwards, as we grow along with the other businesses, the tomato business was more lucrative to us as well.
So, you're in tomato paste also?
Absolutely. We have this tomato ketchups.
Ketchups, and do you have peeled tomatoes, canned ones?
Absolutely. We have that tomato paste also, which is good for cooking and all that. Last year only we have invested the local, I would call it, about a local currency of 35 crore rupees into the pulping plant of ours. And we now have the capability to, from the raw tomato, to make the tomato paste. And now, also,
sorry, Mr. Anthony, if I can remember, when I used to sell these things also from different countries, there is a ratio of mixture inside of what is the strength of that pure. They say 20% pure, 40% pure. I think you use some ratio.
For the paste kind of a thing?
Yeah.
We are, it is more than 99%, it is a original tomato
paste.
Concentrate. It paste,
okay.
Nothing else. And what we are doing is we have a line which is automatically from the raw tomato into the bag, it goes in, it's all automatic. We are packing it aseptically also. We have the aseptic bags, that is the major for the industrial users. That is a aseptic bag which is a foil. Laminated.
So you sell them through foils, cans, and different.
Absolutely,
modes.
we have the retort pouching system as well available to us. So whosoever wants into the bulk, we supply them into the bulk, and for the consumers, we have a consumer packs also.
Okay.
Smaller quantities. That is the pack which is 850 grams. Then we have 450 grams, and then is the last one is the 185 grams.
And Mr. Athar, what are these packets? What are these packets there? Are these spices?
On the right hand side or on the...
No, the right hand.
Right, it is all the tin packaging.
These are all tins. For me it looks like a packet.
No, it's all these tins.
Okay.
And here we are packing the traditional, this spinach. But the saag of Pakistan.
Oh, yeah, yeah. And the methi.
Methi, not the methi.
Palak,
sarson ka saag
aur
palak. Do cheeze humne ispe pack kar rahe hain.
And then I can see peas also.
Peas also.
Yeah.
Then this chicks also.
Chickpeas are also grown in our country.
Absolutely. Absolutely. No. In fact, we have a limited crop available to us, and whatever we have, a good quality of peas, we are converting into this as well. And then we are making the bagare bangan.
You've gone into cooked food also?
Cooked food. There are two kinds of ranges we have. One is ready to eat and one is ready to cook. These chickpeas and others are the ready to cook, and the ready to eat is like of
bangan.
Bagare bangan, haleem.
Haleem is there.
Haleem is there. Then we have not gone into the Nehari as yet, because here it is possible, but for the Europe and others, this meat and beef is a bit difficult.
Okay, so you are all vegetarian things?
Absolutely right.
Okay,
absolutely.
So then you cover a vast market.
Absolutely.
Right.
Absolutely. Whatever we produce for X country, we can produce it. We can
go,
ship it,
can
to
go
the
anywhere.
So we are working on to this poultry and the beef products for certain markets only, or we are into the trial stage at that time, right now. In fact, the largest seller of ours is sarson ka saag.
I can imagine. And my wife, she goes crazy.
And I tell you, this mostly comes into the Middle East, either in Dubai or into Saudi Arabia.
Now, Athar Saab, you have brought me to the question. I was just going to ask you this. Working in our own country, okay, it's a business, you are doing it, but the country is held by exports.
Yes.
So what is the ratio of your product being exported?
In fact, right now, the percentage is not as it should have been. I will tell you, I will share it with you. But the encouraging thing is that our sales export are, from the last 4-5 years, it is always more than what we used to sell in the last year.
So that's your benchmark. Every last year is your benchmark. You
every last year is our benchmark.
Yeah.
And it is growing roughly about 15-20% per annum from the last 2-3 years. Right? You can imagine how fast it is growing and continuously growing, right?
Now is that just...
So it has come about 20% of my business from, let's say, 5-7%. It is ratio is about 50-20. But in the coming years, what we feel, we should have more and more, let's say, exports-oriented markets. Recently, we have got a good, response from Africa as well.
Okay.
No doubt, we are already there in 17 countries.
Now, when you say 17 countries, that means you are working on distributorship naturally.
Absolutely.
So, what is holding you back? Are you not getting that many distributors or your campaign, your marketing? Because I think you can jump from 20 to 70 maybe.
You are right.
There is no restraint in the crop and the food production.
No, at all. In fact, first of all, for our product, we always keep in mind, as Pakistan is an agro-based economy, no doubt it is shrinking. Shrinking means nothing, we have less produce, we have more produce available.
More export.
But in general, our industrialization is also increasing.
They are covering the land.
Wheat we have surplus, rice we have surplus, cotton we have surplus, right? And this tomato paste, which I am just referring it to you, this sarso ka saag and other things, we always, first of all, focus towards the farmers. As an entrepreneur of my, let's say, owner of the company, they first give the thought to the local producers of the products, how best we can support them in shape of getting the produce from them at a right price.
I cannot help saying it, although I should not say it.
Please.
There is no politics, because is happening in our country, they become monopolies and then they put their own price. For example, what is happening with sugar cane and all. I don't want to go into
why I have put this point to you. Last year, we, in the month of February, fixed the prices of the tomato, base tomato, with the local farmers about 100 kilometer radius of our factory. In February, the crop was supposed to get us by May, right? Price and everything was settled with them in advance. If whatever you will produce, we will buy it, and the price is this. That was acceptable to them. They went into this tomato growing, and in May we start getting the crop from them. Can you believe it? Last year, the crop was fantastic, and I was offered less prices of the tomato in the market against the contract farmers of mine.
What you had committed to them.
Absolutely. But we told them, the farmer, others, but our contractor, if we are in this business, we want to remain in this business, we don't want to be opportunists. Whatever we have committed to you, we will buy it. And if we got some surplus, because of nature at times help you of producing more from the soil and all that, then we will buy it. And I buy it. Whatever I committed, I buy it from my farmers and the contract farmers, and the rest.
Okay, now another question.
So that, but we are doing it for the sarso ka saag also.
No, I understand. That's one policy remains.
And what we are doing is, in fact, this initiation of the plant was, first of all, we thought it with the World Food Program, which is helping out Pakistan in different areas, in different businesses, in different products. So they don't came into the business of the pulping plant, but we invested into the pulping plant, and we are now working for the local farmers and all that to grow this.
This brought me to a question which may confuse me later on. You say you buy from all the farmers and all. Doesn't Mitchell as a company have their own farms also?
In tomato we were not now.
Still we are not. That's a third party product.
That is a third party product.
Okay. In fact, we
are, let's say, into lime, lemon, lime, some quantity of guava, some of oranges. Rest we buy it from the market also.
Okay, your main produce is oranges, I marmalade and these type of things.
Absolutely. Yeah. But as we are growing, so we need more, and for more we are getting it right quality
yeah,
from
it
outside
more
of
economical
our
to buy,
absolutely,
yeah,
absolutely.
Correct. Now lime, when you say lime or lemon, are you also in the pickle business? Are you making any pickles? You have. Okay.
And I tell you this pickle preparation and making of pickle is a very different kind of process.
Home recipe.
Home recipe plus there is a seasoning effect into it as well.
Okay, it matures in that thing.
Absolutely.
In these big cakes maybe.
Absolutely. And over the year we have learned it, we should not artificially, let's say, aggregate certain
chemically
vegetables.
Not correct, yeah.
Absolutely.
And then
absolutely.
One, you already have a raw product for this. Your sarso ka oil is already used.
Absolutely.
Right.
So but we have already developed into our system the different stages of the pickles, which takes about 8 to 10 weeks to get matured from the raw thing.
Okay.
So whatever the pickle, once we, let's say, make it ready for the market, that is already passed through different channels of the required time frames of the processing of this pickle.
And there is no acidic problem later on and all. It's good for your health.
In fact, we are exporting it to USA and Canada.
That's good. Okay, Athar Saab, one thing, I'll need your help.
Yeah.
This thing is going online. We'll be sending you the URL. It will be on YouTube, LinkedIn, anywhere, Facebook, and all. If you have any video showing all these products being manufactured, we would love to play it.
When I was discussing it with you, that I just was discussing, I don't have that one film which I have just made it, shoot it. That is from the raw tomato to the end. Just a minute, I have to check it up. Otherwise, I will raise it. Harun, yar, wo tomato processing ki jo hamari video jo banayi thi humne, wo mujhe isi waqt abhi khayal aaya aur maine kaha wo kyun nahi lekar aaye hum, inko to bhej denge. Khair, behrhal, kya koi surat hai ki ek din mein hame wo aa sake aur hum isko ban kar sake? Kaise? वो तो हम कर लेंगे. I have his card.
Yeah.
So I will.
But we can do it next week. We will send you that email.
Yeah, I'll give you my card also.
Yes,
in case, because he looks like a very busy person.
Very.
Although
no,
we
I am doing nothing but busy.
We did the trick of asking him 5 minutes, and we took, I think, more than 5 minutes. Thank you for your time.
It's my pleasure. It's my pleasure. Nice
talking
to you.
And it's proud to talk to people who are innovators. You know.